Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. So this is your video for RBI SEBI NABARD, and also the questions that I discuss can be of use for your banking examinations at the level of PO. So let's begin this video. But the newcomers who are watching this video for the first time, or the people who have not subscribed our channel till now, then guys, do subscribe it and hit the bell notification. This will help you keep updated with the new uploads that we make on our channel. This is the Telegram group where you can directly ask your queries from the mentors on our channel. Also, you can enjoy the free quizzes that we provide on that group. And the link of this group is in description below. So please ensure that you join that group and enjoy the free quizzes. This is the new course for 2022 RBI Grade B, in which we will offer you with PDFs, videos and mocks. Along with, you will also get the interview preparation. So we conduct mock interviews so that you can be prepared for your final interviews of RBI. So along with this, the bonus feature here is that you will get a book kit that will contain all the books mentioned right here in front of you guys. And right now we are running a 30% discount on this course. So if you want to avail that course, then you can use RBI 30 coupon code. And this is the number which you can use to call us if you have any query related to the examination or anything else. So on that note, let's begin the first question of the day. Which IIT has developed a first of its kind Internet of Things device named as MBTAG? So we have IIT Delhi, Ropad, Kharagpur, Roorkee and IIT Hyderabad. Out of these five options, the right answer here is option D. IIT Ropad has developed this MBTAG. Now what is the purpose of this MBTAG? This MBTAG device is basically a USB device, or a device looking like a USB. That would be the precise explanation for MBTAG. So this device basically checks the temperature from 40 degree minus 40 degree Celsius to 80 degree Celsius. Now what is the use? The use is basically to measure the temperature of cold storages or the organs or similar products. So that is the purpose of this MBTAG. Now in recent days, IIT Ropad has also developed a tool called Fake Buster. Now that Fake Buster tool is used to identify the imposters that are attending virtual meetings. So that Fake Buster device is used to identify the fake people who are attending the meeting. Also, that device can also be used to identify faces that are manipulated on the social media networks to mock someone. So that is the basic purpose of this Fake Buster that was developed by IIT Ropad. Now, apart from this, the main thing that you have to remember here is that this MBTAG was developed by IIT Ropad in partnership with two organizations. So what are the names of those two organizations? First is Avadh and second is Scratch Nest. So these are the two organizations that have helped IIT Ropad to develop this MBTAG device. Now, remember this thing that this Scratch Nest is basically a startup opened by the four students of IIT Ropad. So that was all about this question or this news. I would like to hear from you that where is this IIT Ropad located, the state in which this IIT is located. Okay, so the next question is, with which UT government has Go Air signed an MOU for the transportation of perishable horticulture and agriculture produced to various destinations across the country? So we have Daman and Diu and Dadar and Nagar Haveli, Puducherry, Andaman and Nicobar, Delhi and Jammu and Kashmir. So out of these five options, the right answer here is option E, that is Jammu and Kashmir Union Territory has signed this MOU with Go Air. Now guys, your task is to tell me the Lieutenant Governor of this Union Territory in the comment section below. Moving on to the third question. Who has become the first Indian to be elected as the president of International Narcotics Control Board? So Jagjit Pavadia, Nivedita Pandey, Kirti Sharma, Akansha Singh, Purvi Chandela are in the options. Out of these five options, the right answer is option A, Jagjit Pavadia. Now she is also the second woman to hold this position in the world. So remember that she is the first Indian as well as the second woman to be the president of International Narcotics Control Bureau. Now you have to tell me that where is this organization located? who has won the men's singles at the 2021 Emilia Romagna Open. So this is first of all a tennis tournament. Now who has won the men's singles? So we have Rafael Nadal, Novak Djokovic, Sebastian Korda, Andre Agassi and Andy Murray. Out of these five options, the right answer is option C, Sebastian Korda, and he is from America. And remember that he has become the first American to win a European clay court tournament. So here we have come across another fact related to this Emilia Romagna Open, that it was played on clay court. Okay, now where was this held? So this was held in Italy. This Emilia Romagna is basically a region in Italy, and there at this place this tennis tournament took place. Do you guys know that French Open, that is the one of the Grand Slam tournament, also played on the clay court? So this is another fact that you should remember. Now the men's single tournament has been won by this, but who has won the female singles? Who has won the women's singles? So the name of that person is Coco Gauff, and she is also an American. So both of the Americans have won this tournament. So that was all for this question. Now we are moving on to the next question. Who is the author of All Roads Lead North, Nepal's Turn to China book? So this is a new book that has been released recently. We have Jai Kiran Singh, Shakuntala Amish, Raj Mulmi, Gaurav Kumar, Hemant Kumar Nanda in the options. Out of these, the right answer is option C, Amish Raj Mulmi. So here today's video ends. I hope that you have learned something, and if you have, then do not forget to subscribe and hit the bell notification. Thank you so much for watching the video.